This is the gear train from the Mercedes 725.0 9 G-tronic, 9-speed automatic transmission. What we want to do with our V-blocks is to demonstrate the power flow. Now obviously, 9 speeds and 4 separate planetary gear sets and 1 ratio in reverse. Now, as to the symbols, it's hard to see the actual planetary gear sets, but they'll be divided into 4. So, here we see the front planetary gear set, which will be the internal gear, the planetaries, and the sun gear. Now, the sun gear in P1 planetary set is actually going to be splined to the input shaft. Now, as we move further back, we're going to have the second set of planetaries, planetary set 2. Now, the planetary set of P1 is actually going to be connected to the internal gear of planetary set P2 through one of the multiple disc clutches. Now, we actually have 3 multiple disc clutches and 3 multiple disc brakes. Now, the very first multiple disc clutch, this is going to be labeled clutch F. And what it's going to do is it will spline the planetary gear set of P1 to the turbine shaft. This is one of the multiple disc brakes. What it can do is lock the planetary gear set of planetary gear set P1 to the case. As we mentioned, the multiple clutch E, this is one of the rotating clutches, and it will lock the planetary gear set of P1 to the internal gear of planetary gear set P2. The A brake, this will lock the sun gear of planetary gear set P2 to the case. The B brake, this locks the internal gear of planetary gear set P3 to the case. And finally, rotating clutch D, what this can do is lock the internal gear of planetary gear set P4 to the output shaft and also to the planetary of P3, which is through this coupling spline to the output shaft.